Hello class, till here we have completed the construction working of conventional battery ignition system, and even though we gone through the different phases of ignition system need to be completed, that is ionization, arc formation and the arc suspension. Now on this slide we can see a schematic diagram of the conventional battery ignition system. Okay, so this is the conventional battery ignition system schematic diagram. This diagram is supposed to draw in exam. The previous explained diagram was three dimensional, so it is not possible to draw in exam. So let just do it first. Here we will see how the this schematic diagram supposed to correlate with the 3D one. So this is our battery. This is a negative terminal. This is our positive terminal. It's supposed to enter to the ignition switch. This ignition switch is nothing but your key switch. Okay. After the passing through key switch, this wire is connected to the primary winding. This is your primary winding, somewhat thickened wire. Okay, it coming out through ignition coil, it entering to the distributor. There are two circle you can see here. This is also distributor and this one is also a distributor actually, but we are just separating distributor in two portion. Actually this is a cover, or we can say distributor head. Okay, this distributor head supposed to sit on this base. It gets separated. It's, there is a clamp present on the distributor. Through this unclamping, this distributor head can be separated. Okay, from base. So the shaft coming through cam are entering to the rotor. Okay, and that rotor supposed to locate in the distributor head. So this is the one part consider right now. We have just separated by unclamping, so it get it it divided into two circles. Okay, so but actually it is same, it located over and above. Okay, so just our current entering to the here. Okay, through primary winding, this is your capacitor here. Wire coming from the primary winding is split into two end. One is goes to the capacitor and again through dotted line is earth to the vehicle body. Okay, similarly wire half portion or splitted end of the primary winding are going to the contact breaker, and through contact breaker through dotted line is again grounded. So in that way this contact breaker is connected in parallel with the capacitor. You can see as shown in a 3D diagram. Now go to the secondary winding. The one end of the secondary winding is connected to the primary winding. Okay, another end is coming out through the ignition coil and again it enter to the distributor central cap or central rotor. Okay, again this distributor rotor having one needle which is not shown actually here. It's supposed to like this. This needle supposed to like this. It's supposed to rotate in this direction. It's supposed to rotate in this fashion, and it one by one touches the leads. Whenever lead are touching, whenever needle is touching to one of the lead present over here, that time contact is in break condition. Whenever lead is not touching or needle is not touching any of the lead like this, that time this contact breaker make the contact. Okay, in that fashion we have tuned that, in that fashion we have set the timing. Okay, so these are the thing of constructional thing, or we are correlating this two dimensional schematic diagram with the three dimensional diagram which I have explained previously. Okay, so here I'm not going to explain the working, we have already done with that. So you supposed to draw this diagram in your exam. Whenever they will ask you draw or construct, or they will ask you the construction and working of conventional battery ignition system. Okay, so till here we have completed the conventional battery ignition, or we have understood the basic concept of working of ignition system, the basic concept of working of ignition system. Still if you feel any difficulty to understand, ask me on our Google Classroom. Thank you.